Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today we're gonna have a modeling topic and we're gonna be talking about support loops. Now, support loops are a key element that are gonna keep parts of your object in place. They're gonna keep all the curves nicely visible and they will greatly affect the quality of your models. So let me first explain what support loops are. So a support loop is basically an edge that's keeping a specific curved surface in place. So if you have a chamfered surface like this, and here let's say you have a flat surface, you're gonna add your support loop here on that flat surface, and that's actually gonna keep the definition of this chamfer in place and it will look much better. Let me show you what I mean. So I have a box here, and this box has a standard chamfer here. Now, it doesn't have any support loop. How would it look like if it had support loop? Well, it basically would look like this. So you would add one here, one here. Keep in mind, when I'm placing these support loops, it's very important that you place them on a rough distance to the polygon size next to it. So if this is my polygon here and it's part of this whole chamfer, my support loop is gonna go roughly here. So we're generally just making like an extension of these polygons here. Let's make another one here, and that is that. So these are support loops now, and this is how do they look. What happens if you don't have them? So look at this. I'm gonna activate my turbo smooth here. And you can notice, I mean, at first, this is just a box that just has chamfered edges, and we are planning for these surfaces, like all the sides, to be flat. But without the support loops, when I turbo smooth it, you can actually notice that these are curved a little bit. If I want to pronounce this effect, I'm going to lower my segments of the chamfer to 1. And now when I activate turbo smooth, you can actually see that this is far from being flat. Of course, adding segments will make it appear more flatter, but in the end, on a sub level, it's always going to be a little bit curved and your reflection is going to pick up on that. But let's see how this whole thing will perform if I activate my edit poly where I have modeled my support loops. So if I go back to my turbo smooth now, you can notice that this surface is completely flat. Look at this, without support loops, with support loops. Without width. Not only that, just focus on these elements here. So we have this edge here. So this is like this curved surface. When I remove the support loops, you can notice that this curvature of chamfer is actually being lost. So just focus here. Look what happens. Do you see how it gets thinner? Meaning that nice chamfer that you modeled is actually shrink down because not having a support loop basically ate it all up. And what do I mean by that? If I lower my segments to 1 more time, and I'm gonna add support loops this time with inset feature built-in chamfer. So let me just crank it to something like this. So if I turn off my inset, look how these chamfers look like. So you can see that they're actually being shrinked down because they don't have any support loops. And that's a massive definition loss, because if you compare it like this, when I activate my support loops, you can see it's actually a massive, massive difference. Support loops will greatly enhance the quality of your object. Here is the example. So this is this same model of these two boxes. This box on the left, it feels like it's puffy. And you can really see that, by looking at those reflections, you can see how they're bending all around. But the one that has support loops, I know it's a very large chamfer, but here you can see all the things are kept straight. Now, if we increase our segments to, let's say, something like this, and our support loops, let's say here, here I'm also gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna increase my segments to 2 without support loops. You can see the noticeable difference. So look, we are still getting this left box to feel puffy and it's all gonna be curved constantly, while the box on the right, you can actually notice with all the reflections that it actually keeps a straight surface on top. And this is a major, major thing to watch out for. I've seen so many models just using flat chamfer without any support loops, and the model just doesn't perform the way you want it to perform. Here's another example where I model, let's say this is like a cabinet leg or something like that. It's just a chrome leg. And here you can see if you model it in just toss a chamfer on top of it, well, it's gonna look like this. But you can always check if it's worth adding the support loop by generally turning off the chamfer, and you're gonna see how that surface is supposed to look, how a straight surface is supposed to look. And then you kind of try and understand if you need support loops or not. So if I add my chamfer, it will look like this. But if I add my support loops by adding inset again, it's gonna look like this. And this is much closer to the original shape that we see without the chamfer. Now, I don't want all these support loops to add just based on a chamfer modifier. Take a look at this. This is a vase that I modeled, and I generally, as you can see, I created a line, I did a lathe, and then I added some edit poly to just cap some holes. I added some shell on top of it and turbo smooth, and this is it. Let's say you needed to do a profile based on a picture on that. So how do you add support loops on a surface like this? So if I go to my shell, I would click edit poly here, and I would go to my swift loop. Now, for the swift loop, I know that my chamfers generally need to be the size of this polygon here. But what I'm gonna do here, just for the definition, I'm gonna add an edge here, and I'm just gonna pull it up a little bit. So this is my polygon size on this kind of chamfered element, and I'm just gonna add my support loop, aiming that my support loop is roughly this big. So I'm gonna place it here, then I'm gonna place the inner one here. Next, I'm gonna move to the bottom. On the bottom, I'm also gonna place an edge here, an edge here. But you gotta keep one thing in mind. If you take a, like, you know, kind of a closer look at this, we have this edge and this edge. This looks like a raw chamfer. So to make this an actual support loop, we would need to draw them right now, because these are still not supporting anything. Now, how does the final look like? So if I activate my turbo smooth, you can notice that we have much nicer definition everywhere. And if I turn off all the support loops that I did, look at this difference. It's just a massive difference. Now, if I go to my wireframe, you can see how this edge is nicely rounded, nicely pronounced. And if I didn't add the support loops, it would generally look like this. And this is not the look you're aiming for. So without the support loops, you are preserving a lot of the shape that you're modeling, and you're generally showing it off in the best possible way. Same thing happens with the bottom here. So if you look at it before and after, it's just a massive, massive difference. So the more you kind of generate the habit of creating support loops on any model that you do, you will notice that you're gonna get a much nicer renders, because all your shapes are going to be all nicely pronounced and everything is going to be nicely visible. But you know who also uses support loops? Evermotion. And Evermotion has this nice Black Friday deal here. It's 50% off. It's 2 days remaining, so I hope you manage to grab some of these cool ass deals. Look at these trees there. They look fantastic. So yeah, this is a really, really nice deal that they're having here. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you, Evermotion, for sponsoring this video. See you in the next video. Bye.